So we are approaching West End, which is the main top island next to South Farallon, and we're going to zip line across the Jordan Channel to get there.
Ross Donihue and Marty Schnure are on the remote Farallon Islands, less than 30 miles off the coast of San Francisco.
Oh, man.
Together, they're making an interactive map of the island's various landscapes and landforms.
So, let me just give you a little sense of where we are. This is Garbage Gulch, right here. And over there, where the crane is East Landing. We are on Southeast Farallon Island. Here's Ross.
Most people don't know that the Farallons even exist. The islands are technically within the city limits of San Francisco. Ross and I are cartographers, so we're really excited to make an interactive map to allow people to explore the islands from afar.
To make their map, they need to collect data on every feature of the landscape, from top to bottom, getting to the hard-to-reach spots in whatever way they can, surveying landforms like gulches, ridges, and hilltops, as well as features you can't see from the surface, like caves. And that's where Ross and Marty are headed next.
We're meeting up with the researchers to go over to Fertilizer Flat and into a cave, so it's pretty exciting.
Cave's small entrances can make for a tight squeeze. But once inside, their size can surprise even experienced explorers like Ross and Marty.
So Rabbit Cave is a cave inside of Lighthouse Hill on Southeast Farallon Island, and we're all the way at the end. And we've crawled through in order to do sort of a rough mapping of the cave. And it's really neat to be in here because it's totally quiet. And the only sound is water dripping from the roof. Pretty neat.
Caves are large underground landforms that can take hundreds of thousands of years to form. They can be sculpted by waves, cooled lava, even rainfall. Caves often have a complex web of twisting underground passageways. As a result, they're some of the least explored landforms on Earth. Ross and Marty want to change that.
We are currently inside the biggest chamber. So we wriggled through some tunnels in the beginning, and it opened up into this, which is about the chamber about 30 feet wide and about 25 feet tall. And then just a little bit further through the tunnel over there is the end of the cave.
And one of the things that we're trying to do is actually map out the cave. So each square represents a certain distance, and we're able to create a schematic for what the cave looks like. And with this information, we can incorporate that into our maps and our communication tools for the public to be able to see.
Each natural landform and landscape is unique. By including pictures and videos in their maps, Ross and Marty try to make each one tell its own story.
The Farallon National Wildlife Refuge is completely off limits to the public. And, you know, that's why we're here. We're out here to capture the essence of this place so that we can bring it back to the mainland.